trying to raise the concrete jungle in place of green jungle.
It was a pleasant morning in a gloomy forest. There lived five friends: elephant, rabbit, monkey, peacock, and parrot. They always stayed together happily, playing and helping each other.
That morning sun peeks over the mountains, and all the rhinos rub their eyes when they hear the jungle rhythm. Those birds are tap, tap, tap in the tree trunks. The busy bee hums as he flies loud and clear to the jungle rhythm. Now you can hightail it out of the jungle, but it never leaves your heart. First you feel that beat start bubbling under, then hear the tom-tom's loudest thunder. It's Marv and me. Sounds a lot like being free when you feel the jungle rhythm.
A man came with his friends for a visit to the forest.
Owner, look at this place. This is perfect place to construct our factory. No disturbance for our work. Let us work on this immediately. Very soon, they started the construction work.
Workers look at the tree and again start cutting.
Tree 1. I will give you lots of fruits, vegetables, and flowers. I give nice shade when it's sunny. I give you oxygen. Please don't cut me.
Animals seeing so many humans' presence did not come outside much. So they all were very sad seeing so many trees who were their friends.
Monkey, these humans have come to disturb us. What shall we do now?
Parrot, the only way is to move to the neighboring jungle.
So they all moved to the neighboring jungle, which was adjacent to the current place. As they were too disturbed by the noise of the factory, pollution in the lakes. After settling down, they all felt refreshed and felt freedom.
Walking in the jungle, walking in the jungle. We're not afraid, we're not afraid. Walking in the jungle, walking in the jungle. We're not afraid, we're not afraid.
Few days later, the monkey saw that the factory owner again in this jungle with his team.
Monkey, again these people have come here. What are they doing here now? Let's listen to what they talk.
Owner, okay team, we have successfully built our factory and all is going fine. Now it is time to expand our business. We are going to construct some apartments and sell out some areas in form of plots. All approvals are received. We are going to start our work soon.
Monkey felt sad and went back to his place and told his friends on what he saw. They all were shocked to hear this.
Elephant. Oh no, not again. Just now we got settled in this area. Now again they came back.
Peacock. Why are they always troubling us? Why can't they let us live in peace?
Rabbit. Before they start any work and spoil this place in front of our eyes, let's start shifting further inside so they don't trouble us anymore.
So they all decided to leave this jungle immediately and they moved to the next jungle. It took time for them to settle down, but they all helped each other. Few days later, the parrot was sitting on a tree and was feeling sad while watching his old jungle was destroyed completely. He was recollecting all the good memories he had in that place.
Parrot, I miss my house there. We have played happily there on the branches of the tree. Lots of flowers, fruits, vegetables used to be there. It was so green. But now everything is gone.
Suddenly, she heard someone talk. It was that factory owner with his team. Curious to know what he was up to now, she flew and went near them.
Owner, my dear team, successfully we have finished two projects without any trouble. Now we are going to our third project. We are going to build a luxurious resort with lots of amenities. We shall also have a shopping mall nearby and will construct a theater to attract the crowd. We will also be constructing a sports ground in that area very soon.
Was shocked after hearing this and left that place immediately to inform her friends.
Monkey. Again? Peacock. What shall we do now? The next jungle is very small and there is another city that side where lots of humans are present. Rabbit. Why are they harming us so much? We didn't do any bad to them. Elephant. It's high time we are patient and adjusting for them. Let us work together in stopping them from troubling us further. Monkey. He is right. Let us make a wise plan and stop them from attacking any jungle around.
They all decided to teach that factory owner a lesson and started making a plan. Next day night, Elephant went to the apartment area and ate up all the leaves of the coconut trees and banana trees. He scattered all the wood logs and other construction materials kept there and made the place look ugly. That morning, owner was too upset seeing this condition.
Owner.
Oh, good heavens! What happened to this place? Why is this place such a mess? Who did all this? Next day night, Rabbit went there and dug holes all around the play area, walking path, garden, etc. Oh, what is all this? This is worse than yesterday. I wonder who was doing all that. Next day, Peacock flew and made holes on all the doors and windows and made the place look even uglier. Owner,
to spoil my name in this industry, I'm not going to spare that guy to damage my property. Tonight, I will find out who is behind all this and will teach them a lesson. So next day, Ona was hiding along with his team to find out what's happening. To his surprise, a parrot and a monkey was passing by. He ignored them first. Monkey slowly goes around and started eating the fruits and vegetables along with the parrot. It went inside houses too to check if anything available and started scattering the food. Seeing this, Ona got angry and told his team to catch the monkey and parrot.
Ona, so you two are the ones who were destroying my place all this while?
Monkey, ha ha ha, your place, ha ha ha.
Seeing their friends got caught, other three of them also rushed there. First, Ona was shocked to see the elephant, but then started talking again.
Ona, why are you laughing? Why did you do like this? You spoiled the entire place. I am on a huge loss. I will surely punish you for doing this.
Monkey, that's exactly what we did when you destroyed our place. Parrot, you entered our area without our permission and started constructing so many buildings. You killed our friend, PP1. We are the main cause for getting rain. Without our help, only you breathe oxygen. Without us, how will you get fruits and vegetables? You humans never think about that and destroy us for your selfish needs.
Oh no, I'm really sorry. I can understand how much I have hurt you all. I have never realized of the animals and birds and trees in my path of earning money. I promise that from now, I will not destroy any forest and will make sure I will plant more trees around. I will work for the betterment of saving forests and ensure I will give awareness to all in the city. This was really an eye-opener for me. Thank you, everyone.
Parrot, as long as you have realized your mistake, we are happy. But please remember that whenever animals are sighted in your place, it is nothing but it has come in search of its old place. Whenever there is flood in a city, it means the water is searching for the water bodies once existed.
And they all left to their jungle and were living happily. Ona kept the goat in front of the jungle.
Wonderful message. Friends, if you have observed, the kind of patience that the trees exhibited standing there without moving, a big round of applause to those trees. They were standing there undisturbed and they were continuously there helping their friends to perform the skit well. Thank you, trees. Thanks a lot. And all the other children who have played the part of the animals also excellent. Their part is excellent. Thank you. Thanks a lot.